Hello there, watching us from wherever you're at, whether at home, whether you're the street moving and you're caught up between moving on and actually holding yourself while you're standing, because this is Youth Talk, where we get to hold the hottest topics for discussions. Right as you can see, seated by me, I have students from different schools, so they'll be introducing themselves. And of course, we have an interesting topic coming your way. So basically, myself, growing up as a kid, my parents were not shy to tell me about the topic called sex. They told me everything, all the facts, all there is to know about sex, and I actually abstained. I may still be abstaining, but that's a topic for a different day. Right now, let's get to interact with my students here. I'm going to be passing the microphone so they introduce themselves, the schools they are from, so we get to know them. So you say your name and the school you're representing.
I'm Achiradim Patience from St. Lawrence Citizens High School, Horizon Campus, Ace 5, doing Divinity at Geography, / ICT.
Anes Eninde, coming from Namiliango College, I'm in Form 3.
I'm Chemik Shanita from St. Lawrence Crown City Campus, I'm in Form 3.
I'm Nachiwala Tania, Ruaga Girls, Form 2.
Nachitanda Martha, Trinity College, Nabingo, Form 3.
Okay, so Martha, starting with Martha, I want to hear from you. What do you know about sex education? First, define the word for me. What is sex education?
According to me, sex education is where the youth or the people are educated about sex, how to abstain, the diseases, anything connected to sex is sex education.
Okay. So tell me, when did you first hear about sex education? What age was that?
I remember it was P6 when we were learning about reproduction. Yeah, that's when I got to know about sex education.
What exactly did they tell you about sex education?
They told us to abstain, to abstain from sex so that we don't get the STDs and the HIV/AIDS.
Yeah. Okay, then my immediate neighbor. What age did you get introduced to sex education?
Well, the same as she said, I was also in P6 when we were taught about the topic of reproduction. They taught us different stages we are going to undergo as we are growing up, and they also taught us many ways of how sex is useful and how it is also bad if you do it at the wrong time.
Okay, yeah, sometimes sex is actually done at a wrong time for these youngsters. Am I abstaining?
Yeah.
That was a hesitation. Did anyone else feel that? You're abstaining, right?
Yes, of
course. How old are you?
I am 15.
Wow, yeah. So what is the cause of your abstinence?
Well, the cause of my abstinence from sex is the fact that in P6 we're taught that if you go into that activity, especially at such a young age, you get STDs. And according to the church, it is not good to have sexual intercourse outside wedlock. So perhaps I'm waiting after marriage, and then I don't know, it will happen there. But as for now, I'm abstaining from sex to keep myself safe.
Wow, seems like I have a fellow born again in the house. You're waiting for marriage. Do you have a boyfriend?
Probably no.
What is the probably for? It's either yes or no.
Because I believe this isn't the right age. You don't expect me to tell my mother I have a boyfriend.
So she's watching and no, that's your worry.
No, that's not my worry, but it's not appeasing. It's not really good for a parent to listen that you have a boyfriend or what. This is not the right age, but currently I'm 18. I'm an adult. I decide what to do for myself. So apparently dating is not the best option for my age because I'm still a teenager. I'm waiting to get 20 and above.
Okay, but we can't escape the fact that we have relationships in school. So, what school again?
St. Lawrence Citizens High School.
Yeah, that is an international school. I know coupling is like so common. You've never coupled, you mean?
Well, I'll not deny I have ever coupled.
Oh my God, share your experience.
The experience is not actually good for our age. So, it's better for one to run away from it so that you can, you know, concentrate on books. Because no one couples and you really excel. You get the point? No one couples and you really concentrated because you want to get something on board, but then your boyfriend is sending cheats, that's all that nonsense. So the best thing to do is, you know, to keep away from it and to first concentrate on studies. Then after campus, you can think about the next step.
Okay, thank you so much. Yes, so now I want to ask all of you to share what particular thing you were taught at a young age. For me, in my time, my mom referred to sex as bad manners. So for you, what did your mom call sex when you were young? That like, don't do this, don't, for me that would be like, don't do bad manners.
My mom told me about that as a bad act. It's very satanic and not good for our health, yeah.
Okay, satanic, what a huge word. Anyway, so there's something called sexual harassment. Sexual harassment is any act of sex that is against anyone's will. So if a man walked up to you, a young girl, let's say a sugar daddy, and he's willing to give you something, maybe a small gift, some money, a small parcel for sex, that is sexual harassment if you're not willing. So what would you do if a sugar daddy approached you?
I would obviously say no.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Why would you say no? As in, this is money. You may want to buy something, so...
No, at least that something can wait, but my health can't wait.
Yeah, like those diseases.
Yeah.
Let's hear her opinion. Would you say no or you would say yes?
I would definitely say no. Because the reason as to why I'm still in school, my parents have taken me to school to help me learn more. But now, if I show them that what they are doing is useless, I still need more money, my parents are giving me enough money, so I should be satisfied with what they have given me.
Okay, thank you so much. Yeah, so this is one gentleman on the show. Let's hear from the perspective of a young man. Now, there are so many attractive girls, of course, around your age. Has any girl ever approached you, like, without you approaching them first?
No. No girl has approached.
They don't even wink at you. You know school?
No. I'm in a single-sex school.
You've never had a crush?
Personally, no.
So in other words, he's abnormal. I don't believe this. You've never had a crush?
Okay.
Like, there's no girl you look at and you're like, wow, I wish she was mine or something.
Yeah, the crush comes, but because I want to develop myself, because I want to live up to that age whereby I can say I have a legacy. I never did this, I never did that. I keep away from that. I suppress that feeling and continue with life because it's not worth having sex at such a young age. It's not worth having a relationship at such a young age when I know it's going to divert me from my goals, my dreams. I want to make money. I want to have an impact on the world. How will I feel it psychologically when I am trying to do this and this still comes back my mind, hey, this girl. So I just put it down and continue to develop myself here.
Okay. Let's hear from somebody who's 18. You're more of an adult, you know? At least 18 and over. So let's say some of the teenagers out there already engaged in two relationships, they're already having sex. What's your best advice to those who are actually already engaged in the act?
Well, if you're engaged into the act and you're still a teenager, most especially when you're below 18, then that's a wrong thing you're doing. Because you can't tell what's going to happen. You can get STDs, you can get pregnant. Literally, when people fall in love at that age, they blindly fall in love, so they cannot know, they cannot tell what's happening, you get. So they can be into this guy too much. Yeah, the guy is even also a student like you. He's being fed by their parents. So coupling is not bad, but there is this state of coupling whereby you can couple with your friend, but then you can tell them, let's wait. You push on like maybe from 4 months, but you're still abstaining, you don't do anything bad, then that's okay. Then you can get married after.
Okay, thank you so much, guys. It has been wonderful. This has been a wonderful audience. High five. Thank you for coming through. I've loved this particular audience. You guys watch Platform 256 every Saturday at 9:30 a.m. So Zoe has been representing and it has been a wonderful discussion here. Guess where we are? This is Urban TV, where all the action happens, the editing, you know, the production. So basically, I just love the lighting and everything. Do remember that you can always be part of the show by simply getting us on Facebook. That is Platform 256. And my personal handles, that is Bros Zoe G. MC Zoe for now. Till next time. Bye-bye.